things a little bit different this morning, and we're going to celebrate exactly what we've been singing about our God being a waymaker. And how many know He made a way for us in our salvation by sending Jesus? And we're going to celebrate that with communion this morning. So you can be seated. And kids are going to be a part of this morning. They were talking about it downstairs last week. And I think parents, you got an email or a letter home with you this week about how you can engage your kids in communion this morning. And so we're going to celebrate communion together as family. And so kids, I want you to pay attention to this because I know you guys know about what communion represents. And so I want to ask you three questions this morning. What's the most valuable thing that you have that you could give as a gift to somebody? And parents, you can think about this too, but what's the most valuable thing that you have that you could give as a gift to somebody? The second question is this: who do you care about or love enough that you'd be willing to give that gift to? Who would you give that gift to because you love them so much? And then the third question would be, what if you gave that gift to somebody and they chose not to accept it? How would that make you feel? And so as we're talking about communion this morning, God gave His most valuable gift that He could possibly give, His Son Jesus. Amen? That was the most valuable thing. He is His one and only Son. And He didn't just give it to one person. He gave that gift to the entire world. For God so loved the world that He gave His one and only Son. And He gave that gift even though He knew that some people wouldn't want to receive that gift. But this morning, those of us who have received that gift of salvation from Jesus, we get to celebrate that this morning through communion. And celebrate that our God's a way maker. And He sent His Son to be our representatives and establish a covenant on our behalf. And then we get all the benefits of it. That's good news this morning. So I'm going to invite those who are handing out communion to come on up to the front and start handing that out. And as it's coming around, I want you to ponder this gift that you've been given, this gift of salvation. Think about what that means to you. And then in your families, help your kids understand what we're doing this morning, what communion represents. Help them as parents. Teach them. This is a great teachable moment for your kids. And if you came today and you want to do communion with somebody else, feel free to go sit with somebody else and say, hey, can we do communion together? Because it's a family celebration. We're all family. We're all God's kids because of the way that Jesus made for us. Thanks. So I'm just going to give you a minute or two as this is being passed around to ponder this and to help your kids understand what we're about to participate in. So without our faith in Jesus, this is just snack time in the middle of church. But it's our faith in who Jesus is and what He accomplished that turns this snack into something miraculous. It turns it into this sacred thing that means everything to us. So, on the night he was betrayed, Jesus took bread and he broke it and he said, "This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." This bread represents Jesus' body that was broken on our behalf. And in remembrance this morning, we say thank you to Jesus. We remember the sacrifice that was made. He laid down his life for us. Wow. But like we do communion regularly. We talk about the gospel regularly. But every time, you just have to take this second and just go, wow, this is such good news. So Jesus, we thank you for laying down your life for us and offering us new life, forgiveness, freedom, acceptance, that you call us sons of God, daughters of God. And we remember you this morning, and we say thank you. Let's take this bread together. In the same way, he took the cup of wine after supper, saying, "This cup is a new covenant between God and his people, an agreement confirmed with my blood. Do this in remembrance of me as often as you drink it." So this juice represents the blood that was shed by Jesus on the cross to establish that covenant that we now get to be a benefactor of. Jesus gave his life, and we get all the benefits of it. We get the inheritance. We get to be called sons and daughters of God because of what Jesus did. We don't earn it. We don't deserve it, but we get to celebrate it. And we get to participate in it on something that was paid for by someone else. It's too good to be true. And that's why it's the good news. And that's why we get to celebrate this morning and say thank you to the one who made the way for us. Amen? So Jesus, we thank you for the blood that was shed to establish this covenant. We thank you for what this juice represents and how it's a complete life changer for us. And we are just in awe this morning of you, and we say thank you. In Jesus' name, amen. Let me take the juice together. So you can pass your cups to the nearest aisle, and the ushers will come and collect them. Kids, you can actually be dismissed at this time. You can head downstairs to your rooms down there. And we're going to continue to worship this morning. So why don't you stand with me, and we'll continue to dive back into worship.
Speak a 100 billion galaxies. around you or the people here. hearing you, just the groan. Declaring his words. So we're going to keep singing that melody. I want you with everything you have just to lift it up. Lift up that groan. Lift up that voice. Come on. This is so good. He's so worth it. He's outside of our words.
We live.